Good morning class. In today's class we are going to discuss regarding the cost analysis. Okay, so previous and all we have discussed regarding the economies and diseconomies. What is this economy in the what is economy? So we are trying to reduce some cost, that is nothing but economy. Okay, if you reduce the cost and if you sell at this same selling price which is previous one, we will have more amount of profit. Okay, so our concept is to get the profits only in the business. Okay, not only getting profit. If you get profit only, you can serve some more persons. Okay, that means if you want to help anyone, you should have money. Okay, to do that, at least you should have some profit, then only you can share your profit to the social activities. Okay, so that thing we have studied in the economies. Now first and foremost we should analyze what cost is. Okay, when we calculate the cost only, we can identify the profit. Okay, when we analyze what are the different types of costs. When you are able to analyze the cost only, you can think of deciding the selling price and we can know how much amount of profit you are getting. Okay, what happens if you don't know how to analyze the cost? Okay, if you don't know how to analyze the cost, that means how much amount you have spent on some particular product, how much amount of money or time you have spent on the particular product. If you don't know exactly, you may think that you are having more amount of profit, or else you may think that you don't have any profit. This type of issues occur. So definitely you should know how to analyze the cost. Generally most of the persons who do the business do this type of mistake, that they don't know how to analyze the cost and they think that they have more amount of profit, or else they don't know how to analyze the cost and they may think that there is a huge loss for them. Okay, if you analyze correctly the cost of particular product, then only you can fix the selling price by adding your profit. Okay, the profits are difference between the selling price and the cost of production. So generally selling price may not be in our control mostly. Why? Because the same product what we produce may be selling, it may be sold by some other company also, but at low cost. Do you get now? That means if you want to sell a particular bike, if you want to sell it for 80,000 rupees, and if the same type of bike is available in the market by other company at 60,000 rupees, is it possible for you to sell at 80,000 rupees? The same bike type features will be available. Okay, both the bikes will be having same type of features. with the just a change in the little bit amount of design. Okay, it will not be possible for you to sell at 80,000 rupees. So then what you have to do? You should control your cost. You should control your cost, that is in your hand. Okay. So definitely you should know the cost concepts. Okay. So, and also, if you have some business proposal, if you have some business proposal, you must be able to understand how much it cost and at what price we can sell in the market for that particular product. Okay. Then only you can accept that business proposal. If not, you may not, if you don't understand properly the cost concepts, you may not accept, or you may accept the last coming ideas also. Okay, so when we go with this cost concepts, we have different types of costs. First we will see the nature of cost. Okay, first we see the concept and the nature of the cost. So generally cost is referred as an expenditure incurred to produce a particular product or service. Okay, cost refers to the expenditure incurred to produce a particular product or service. So generally when we want something, we have to sacrifice something. That means if you want to eat some food, if you want to eat some food, you must be in a way to you must be able to sacrifice an amount of money. You can't get the food without sacrificing the money, right? Okay. So generally when we talk regarding the cost, we have costs in this manner, right? Generally, they may be monetary and non-monetary. Okay, costs may be monetary and non-monetary. That means we can monitor the cost or we may not monitor the cost. That means we can observe that or we may not observe that particular cost. Okay, if you don't observe properly, we assume that we don't have that cost. Okay, tangible and intangible. Tangible means touch, what we can touch. That is called as tangible and intangible. Which we can't feel, the touch is called as intangible. We can determine it subjectively or objectively. Cost may be determined subjectively or not objectively also. So we can't see some type of costs. For example, pollution. It costs so much. Okay, pollution, noise or traffic congestion, and another dimension of other cost concepts. What does this mean? These are called as social costs. Pollution, we are with our factory, we are polluting the air. Our factory machinery may be making huge amount of noise, which will be leading to the noise pollution. Okay, which may be leading to the noise pollution. And traffic congestion, the same thing. Okay, when we transport our way goods from one place to another place, we transfer those goods from one place to another place with the help of trucks. Okay, so that is also causing some amount of pollution. And not only that, if some people are living near our factory, they get different adverse effects on their health. Okay, it is also some type of social cost. Okay. And also sometimes these factories may produce huge amount of smoke, and which will affect the people, and also the noise. The noise which is caused by the factory, the people who live in and around the factory will be more frustrated and they have dissatisfaction. These are all psychological effects, right? They are also part of cost only, but they are called a social cost, which we can't touch. What we can, this type of cost we can't write in the book, right? Okay. So what are the cost may be? So when we call it total cost and total revenue, this total cost includes the cost of the raw materials, labor, and the other expenses. When we think of the cost, total cost, generally that is the cost of the raw material and the cost paid for the labor, the salary or wages paid by the labor, paid to the labor, and some more other expenses, the rent of the building. This type of cost will be there, the rent of the building, the transportation cost, okay, sales costs. This type of cost will also be occurring. Next, this is the total cost. Okay, well and good. Then what about the total revenue? Total revenue. But if you think for a single unit of product, we call it as cost price and selling price. When we think of the more number of products, if you produce say some 10,000 number of units in a single batch, we talk regarding the revenue, total revenue. How much is the total revenue we have generated on these products? That means how much will be the selling price. And the total cost is the thing what we include all other types of costs, and we create this total cost, labor cost, raw material cost, and other expenses, whatever necessary has to be added, and it will be analyzed. Right? When we subtract this total revenue from the total cost, we get the profit. Okay? We get the profit. And we get the total revenue, we subtract the total cost from the total revenue, you'll get the profit. Okay. So when we go with the cost concepts, so we have different types of costs. First and foremost, we'll see in specific order. First and foremost, what is long run cost and short run cost? First, you'll see what is short run cost and long run cost. Generally, when we go with the time period, long run cost in the sense when all other variables are varying, when all other variables are varied, we are identifying the cost. When will be other all variables varied? If it is time period is more, right? It is called as long run cost. If you see the short run cost, it is short run is a period during which the physical capacity of the room remains fixed. Okay. So generally we call short run cost as generally we previously have seen the short run in the sense short run period in the sense around less than 1 year, it's called a short run. When we talk regarding the long run, it is more than 1 year and up to 20 years. Generally we consider it as the long run period. Okay, so that means at least long run, short run means at least one of the variable is fixed and rest all other variables may be varied. Such type one is called as short run cost. But long run cost is nothing but almost all the factors has changed. At that time, if you calculate the cost, that is called as long run cost. Simply you can remember, simply what you can remember is, if the time period is more, automatically other variables will be varied. Most of the variables, all the variables will be varied. In the short run, not all the variables will be varying. Okay, such type of cost is called as short run cost and long run cost. Okay. Next, fixed and variable costs. Fixed and variable costs. When we talk regarding this fixed and variable costs, so fixed cost is a cost which remains constant for a certain level of time. Okay, ask for certain level of output. Okay, when we talk regarding this flexibility, that means fixed and variable cost, no cost is fixed. Now, generally, when you talk, no cost will be fixed. It will be continuously varying. But can we say it as a fixed cost, which is not going to vary in the short run? Okay. Fixed cost includes the salaries, rent, administrative expenses, depreciation. All these are called as fixed costs. What is this depreciation? What is this depreciation? Depreciation you can understand easily, right? How? If you buy a new bike in the month of July, for example, if you buy a new bike in the month of July, that means if you buy a bike on July 1st, August 1st, and September 1st. So mostly almost 2 months and 15 days. That means almost it is 75 days, for example. You bought a new bike before 75 days, and you don't like that bike. No. Just you bought 75 days back only. What you are willing to do? You think of selling that one. You think of selling that particular bike. Okay. If you want to sell that bike, are you going to, if you buy that particular bike at a cost of 80,000 rupees, is it possible for you to sell at the same cost? No, it's not possible to sell the same bike at that cost. Or else, if you bought a new bike yesterday itself, if you bought a new bike yesterday itself, and if you say to anyone, if you want to sell that bike today, definitely they will ask reduction in the cost. Why? Because that is called depreciation. Okay. And we can also say that, other example, once upon a time we used to have the cost of price at 20 to 25 rupees only. Now it is around 50 rupees. That means the cost of rupee has depreciated. The cost of rupee has depreciated, right? Okay. That is called depreciation. Generally, when you buy a particular product, and we start using it, its value get depreciated. Okay. So when we talk regarding the fixed cost and the variable cost, fixed costs are the one which will be fixed. That means within the short run of time, the short period of time, the cost will be fixed. There is no variation in that. That means the salary, we don't change the salaries every month. Okay. We will be giving the increment only yearly once for the employee. Okay. Rent also, we don't pay every month. We don't, that means we don't pay extra rent every month. There will be hiking the rent only generally for 1 year or 1.5 year, right? Administrative expenses also, there will not be more changes in administrative expenses of the office. So if you have a company, you have to maintain office, right? If you want to maintain office, you have to provide some minimum resources such as drinking water or the guests who come to you, you have to give coffee or tea or else any other cool drinks or any other things, and maintenance, okay, for the cleaning purpose, the person who cleans that, you have to pay the money to him. These all comes under the administrative office, right? So administrative expenses. Okay. So variable costs. We have a variable cost. So our raw material, labor, direct expenses. So generally it will be varying. That means labor in the sense they will be paid on daily basis or else they will be paid on a weekly basis. Previous month they might have worked for a day, the cost of the labor might have worked at a cost of 400 rupees. After this month they may demand for 500 rupees. Or say more 15 rupees extra. Why? They may tell you different types of things, right? They may tell you different types of concepts. Again, the cost of the living goods has increased a lot, the rent has increased. This type of concept they may tell you. Okay. So these type of things comes under the raw material. When you are for your company, the variable cost will be in the raw material. The raw material will be generally vary. The labor cost and direct expenses, some transportation cost will be increased. Transportation cost will be increased. Why? Because the changes in the petrol cost. Nowadays, the petrol and diesel costs are varying day to day. Every day there is a variation in the petrol and the diesel cost almost. Automatically, there will be huge increase or decrease in the expenses. That means the variable cost, right? We also have some semi-fixed and semi-variable costs. Okay. Very short span of time. If it is increasing the very, that means within the period of 6 hours, if there is increase in the cost after 6 to 9 months, we may call it as semi-fixed. But it is not going to vary every month. That we can call semi-fixed in a similar fashion as the semi-variable cost also. And what is this marginal cost? Marginal cost means generally, you don't find here, but we have to know these concepts also. Okay. Marginal cost is the one. Okay. If you produce one good in extra, that the cost. So, for example, if I am generally producing 100 number of goods, if I want to produce 101 good, okay, the cost occurred for producing one extra good, that is called as the margin cost. So, margin cost is the additional cost incurred to produce an additional unit of output, or it is the cost of the marginal unit produced. Okay. So we may have some controllable costs and uncontrollable costs also. Please be online. Okay. So this thing we have already seen, total cost and average cost. Total cost is nothing but the overall cost. If you produce 100 number of goods, the cost what you have that spent on that producing of 100 goods is called as generally total cost, and the average cost is this total cost divided by the number of quantity produced, that becomes the average cost. Okay, so just we see here. So generally we call this opportunity cost and outlay cost. Okay, this outlay cost is also called as actual cost. Okay, and opportunity cost, in a sense, if we have actual cost and opportunity cost, when we say this terms is, for example, if you have invested the profit what you got in some shares and if you got more amount of profit, say for example, if you have invested the profit what you got around 1 lakh rupees in shares 6 months before, it might be now 1,50,000 rupees, for example. But by doing the business, but you invested that 1 lakh rupees in the business itself, now the cost, that means now that for 1 lakh rupees you got only 1,25,000 rupees you get now. That means if you have invested in the shares, that particular 1 lakh had become 1,50,000 rupees, but now you invested it in the business, that 1 lakh rupees became 1,25,000 rupees only. Now what is your opportunity cost? That is around 25,000 rupees your is the opportunity cost. That means you lost some profit. Okay, that is called as opportunity cost. And this is the actual cost, you can see that. Outlay cost is nothing, also called as explicit and implicit costs. So this explicit and implicit costs are nothing but which involves the cash payments. Explicit costs are those expenses that involves the cash payments. So these implicit costs are different, little bit different from that of explicit costs. So explicit cost, in the sense you have to pay some money to the others. So implicit cost is in the sense if you are starting a business, if you do the business in your own place, that means you have a place called say you have some plot area, and if you do start business in that your own plot, that is generally implicit cost. Why? Because you have to pay the money to yourself. Generally what every business person will be doing is this mistake. If he takes some land as rent from others, the total area what he is using is the rented one, means that is no problem. Generally what they is to do is they will take, if the total company, that means total factory, requires 4 acres of land, they will be using their own 2 acres of land and others 2 acres of land. They will be paying the rent to the other 2 acres of land, and these 2 acres of land, that means which is their own, they forgot to take the rent of a particular their land. Okay, they think that it's the our land only, no problem. They will be thinking that. No, you have to consider the rent to your own land also, and you has to take that one aside. That is called as implicit cost. Okay, that means for others 2 acres, you are paying a rent of 2 lakh rupees per year. Okay, that means you are losing 2 lakhs of rupees when you invest your own land there. If you don't consider that, right? You have to be careful in this type of concepts. That is called as self-owned factors, right? Historical and replacement costs. We have some assets. So we have some assets. That means your grandfather or your great grandfather has given you some amount of land. Okay. At that time, just 40 to 50 years back, it may be in the terms of thousands. Okay, are hundreds. Okay, now it has changed to lakhs and crores. So the previous cost is nothing but a historical cost. And for example, if you want to this replacement cost, in the sense if you have a land in some other area, but now you don't require that land, but you require the land here where you do the business, what you have to do? You will sell that particular land, and some more amount of money is required to buy the land, same amount of land here where you do the business. That means the same amount of land there and here, but you have increased the, there is increase in the cost for your company, right? Why? Because here the land is expensive than that. Okay, short run and the long run costs. So that is based upon the period. There will not be much difference. We have already discussed it. Okay, output, out of pocket cost and book cost. What is this out of pocket cost and book cost? Out of pocket cost means we have to pay now itself. That means we have to pay current cash payment. Okay. We have to pay the money within the near future. That means we have to pay the cash payment. Then what about the book cost? Book cost, in a sense, we can make the person to wait. It is not necessary to pay immediately to him. When we are doing the business, definitely we will take loan, or we will take this, what you say, we will ask the person who supplies the raw material to send the raw material, and we will be paying that person the money with some time period. That means with some lately we will be paying the money to them. So we have to write how much amount we have to pay to so and so person. Okay, that is called as book cost. Okay, so you know what is fixed cost and the variable costs. Okay, past and future costs, post and future cost. Okay, post costs are also called as historical costs. So this is only meant for valuation purpose. Okay, these future costs are nothing but these are expected to occur in future. We expect something. That means in near future there may be some expense. Such type is called as a future cost. Okay, so someone will be the traceable and common costs. So these traceable costs are also called as direct costs. Okay, so these will be generally raw material, labor involved in production is an example of a traceable cost. There's a direct cost only. Common costs are the ones common attributed particular process of product. So generally these common costs cannot be identified. Okay, generally we can identify this traceable cost directly, but common cost cannot be identified. Okay, avoidable and unavoidable costs. Okay. You can the so for example, if anyone come to your office, you may be spending money from your own pocket, right? You may be the owner of the company, but you sometimes you will be using your own money to get the favor for the company, right? So that is called as common cost, which we can't trace out. Okay, avoidable and unavoidable costs. Okay, so avoidable cost means which we can control it, that will be avoidable. And unavoidable costs, we can't avoid some costs. For example, if your products are moving in a truck from one place to another place, meanwhile that truck driver might have done some accident to some animals, say some goat or else any other thing. Okay, and he will call you and say that, sir, here we met with an accident, these persons are demanding money, what can I do? Okay, then what is his intention? That means he has to pay money there. So these type of costs are unavoidable. We can't control those. Okay, here they have given an example of ideal machine capacity. That means we might have bought some machinery and now it is not in use. That is called as generally idle machine cost. Okay, so avoidable and unavoidable and controllable and uncontrollable cost almost are same. Incremental cost and sunk costs. So sometimes the cost will be increasing. That is generally incremental costs. So for example, here adding new machinery, replacing the machinery by better ones. adding a new product. These are called as incremental costs. Next, sunk cost, in the sense they will not be altered. Okay, these are costs incurred in the past, right? If you have an agreement with the landlord that there should not be any change in the rent or the lease for more than 5 years or 10 years, those are called as sunk costs. Okay, which will not be varied. Accounting costs and economic costs. So accounting costs, in the sense we have to pay some money to the accountant. Without paying money to the accountant, we can't hire him, right? So those for hiring him, we have to pay some money. That is called as accounting cost. Economic cost is nothing but sometimes to avoid some failures, we have to keep some money on it. So for godown, if you have produced huge amount of output and it has to be stored, we have to pay some amount for it, or else your goods will be damaged. That is called as economic costs. Okay, we'll see in the next class this other cost and output relationships, and if at all any other costs are available, we'll see in the next class. Okay, see you in the next class.